one of the final jobs to do on Sam's car now is the cold side boost pipe. So I've already knocked it together in the ice engine works plastic, which is now covered in Sam's fresh underseal. And we're gonna do this from titanium, same as the other side. I've cut some pie cuts already, already got them cleaned up. But I'll just run through how this is gonna fit and how we're gonna make it, and then start tacking some materials together. So I made it all as one piece, but obviously we're not gonna fit it through the hole in the chassis leg. The Skyline has a hole in the chassis leg where the boost pipe goes through, or inner wing, whatever you wanna call it. And so we need to kind of split this piece in an ideal place that we can actually fit the boost pipe. I had a 6-inch straight in the middle here. So at the minute, I've just kind of cut that in half just to see how that fits. So I'm just gonna try and thread it through the hole and see if it'll go. Because again, I'd like to be able to do it without kind of scratching it all up and knowing that we're gonna have to get it in and out in the future as well. So that goes in there quite nicely. That shoves up onto the inlet manifold there. And then down here, that should hopefully go something like that. Yeah, so that'll be fine as two pieces. To be honest, I could probably shorten it down even more, which I might do, because that would make it easier to get it in and out. I'm just gonna take off two more of them, stick them on here, because that'll make that tons easier to get in and out then. Yeah, so that literally just drops in through that hole nicely, it says. Yeah, so that goes in there just like that. Got a little bit straight, obviously there'll be a bead on there. And then you got the pipe poking through the other side. And that should be spot on. Obviously it's a bit long at the minute. By the time I roll beads on these, they'll actually reduce in length by a few millimeters. And although I've got 6 pieces of straight, I actually wanted it a little bit shorter, but obviously the Ice Engine Works blocks only come in 1 inch long or 25 mil. So I actually already kind of cut a piece that's a bit shorter. I'm obviously now gonna trim another piece off that and then put beads on them. But yeah, so just a case of now kind of replicating this on the bench and getting it to fit how we want. So we'll just tack a load of these together and then just try it back on. Right, so I've got these bits tacked together now. I will have to put more tacks on them before I weld them, obviously. But what I need to do is check them back on the car now. So before, it was kind of like this, I think. So it's just a case now of seeing if I've got all of my rotations right on this piece and that it still fits. Hopefully it will. And then we can get it welded up and put some beads on it. So it's not perfect, but it's well within tolerance really, given that there's silicon coupler either end and then one in between the two pipes. And I've got my lengths about spot on as well. So by the time I get beads rolled on there, there'll be a nice little gap. Obviously as we roll the bead on it, it actually brings the end of the tube in. It reduces the length of it because you're kind of manipulating the tube out, so there's less material, so it kind of shrinks down a bit. Yeah, so by the time I've done that on both ends, should be pretty close. It'll be perfect, I guess. So yeah, just a case of getting it super clean now and then welding it up. A lot of welding there.
Got
got these all welded up now. So before I go ahead and polish them, I'm going to put a bead on the end of them all. That's a fairly quick, easy job. But yeah, I need to do that before, because sometimes you end up with a little bit of a burr. It kind of makes the end of the pipe a little bit sharp. So I'll sand that down again before I then polish them. Then it's just a case of polishing the living daylights out of it, getting it as shiny as we possibly can. And then, some hitting it with the propane torch some more. That's it, all propaned up, and try to match the other side as best we can. And then obviously the intake pipes as well. So yeah, there's a whole lot of titanium on this. It's been a good chance to have a go at doing a kind of bulk load, because it's not something we've done a whole lot with, really. Obviously it is quite expensive, so generally you don't kind of use lots of it. So that means you don't get to weld lots of it. But yeah, it's been a really good experience, and can definitely feel like we're making some improvements in the process. Just got to get some silicon couplers for it now. Got all those ordered. And then that's pretty much it. We've made everything there is to make. There's going to be a few bits and bobs to finish. And then there's the coolant lines and things like that. We might film a little bit of that, I'm not sure. But yeah, we're almost there.